हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी लर्न अबाउट द न्यू चैप्टर कोल एंड पेट्रोलियम। इन दिस चैप्टर फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस अबाउट द रिसोर्स। देर आर द टू काइंड ऑफ द रिसोर्स, द नेचुरल रिसोर्स एंड ह्यूमन मेड रिसोर्स। वी यूज वेरियस मटेरियल्स फॉर आवर बेसिक नीड्स। सम ऑफ देम आर फाउंड इन नेचर एंड सम हैव बीन made by human efforts. So the substance which we found from the nature is known as natural resource, and the substance which we obtained by the human efforts is known as human made resource. All things which are obtained from nature, they are called natural resource. Classification of natural resource in two group, inexhaustible and exhaustible. Further, the exhaustible natural resource is classified in two group, renewable and non-renewable resource. Resources which we divide in inexhaustible and exhaustible natural resource, the resource are present in unlimited quantity in nature and are not likely to be exhausted by human activities are known as inexhaustible natural resource. For example, sunlight, air. The exhaustible natural resource are the such type of natural resource. The amount of these resource in materials limited, in nature limited, they can be exhausted by human activities. So such type of natural resources are known as exhaustible natural resource. For example, forest, wildlife, minerals, coal, petroleum, natural gas, all fossil fuels are exhaustible natural resource because the rate of consumption is more than rate of formation. The natural resources like coal, petroleum and natural gas, these were formed from the dead remains of living organisms, which is known as the fossils. So these are known as fossil fuels. First we see the coal. It is as hard as stone and is black in color. Coal is one of the fuels used to cook food, and earlier it was used in railway engines to produce steam to run the engine. It is also used in thermal power plants to produce electricity. The coal is also used as a fuel in various industries, as well as the coal is used as fuel in our house. Now come to the study of coal, how the formation of coal is takes place. About the 300 million years ago, the earth had dense forest in low-lying wetland areas. Due to natural processes like flooding, these forests got buried under the soil. As more soil deposited over them, they are compressed. The temperature also rose as they sank deeper and deeper. Under high pressure and high temperature, dead plants got slowly converted into the coal. Now we can see the coal mine here. In this coal mine, the coals are obtained from deep under the soil by mining it, and the coal contains mainly carbon. The slow process of conversion of dead vegetation into coal is called carbonization, and the period in which carbon is get deposited over the coal is known as Carboniferous age. Since it was formed from the remains of vegetation, coal is also called as a fossil fuel. When heated in air, coal burns and produces mainly carbon dioxide gases. When the coal is processed in industry to get some useful products, that is the destructive distillation of coal. This process is when the coal is get heated about the 1000 degrees Celsius temperature in absence of air, then the coal is converted into the coke and also give other kinds of products such as coal gas, ammonium liquid and coal tar. So the coke, coal gas, ammonium liquid and coal tar, these are the product which we obtain from the destructive distillation of the coal. Coke, it is tough, porous and black substance. It is an almost pure form of carbon. Coke is used in the manufacture of steel and in the extraction of many kinds of the metals. Coal tar, it is a black thick liquid with an unpleasant smell. It is a mixture of about more than 200 substances. That means when we again do the destructive distillation of coal tar, the product of coal, that it now give the more than 200 new substances. These substances may be used for the synthetic dyes, drugs, explosives, perfumes, roofing materials, as roofing materials, paints and naphthenyl balls used to repel moths and other insects are also obtained from the coal tar. So these valuable substances we can be prepared from the coal tar, and the coal tar is the product of the coal. Coal gas is obtained during the processing of the coal to get coke. It is used as a fuel in many industries situated near the coal processing plants. Now come to the petroleum. It is used as a fuel in light automobiles such as motorcycles, scooters and car. Heavy motor vehicles like trucks and tractors run on diesel, so that the petrol is used for the light vehicles and the diesel is used for the heavy vehicles. All these components, petrol, diesel, kerosene, bitumen, paraffin wax, these are the product of the petroleum. After refining of the petroleum in refinery centers, these products are obtained in different container, in different fractions, is known as fractional container or fractional distillation. The process is known as fractional distillation. Now first we see the formation of petroleum. Petroleum was formed from organisms living in the sea. As these organisms died, their bodies settled at the bottom of the sea and got covered with layers of sand and clay. Over millions of years, absence of air, high temperature and high pressure transformed the dead organisms into petroleum and natural gas. The petroleum is a dark oily liquid. It has an unpleasant odor. It is a mixture of various constituents such as petroleum gas, petrol, diesel, lubricating oil, paraffin wax, etc. The process of separating the various constituents, fractions of petroleum is known as refining. It is carried out in a petroleum refinery. The various constituents of petroleum and their uses we can see in this table. The liquefied petroleum gas, petrol, kerosene, diesel, lubricating oil, paraffin wax, bitumen, these are the products which we obtain from the petroleum in the different container in the refinery center. These can be used as in different way, such as the LPG is used as a fuel, petrol is used as a fuel in motor, kerosene is also used as a fuel in the lamps, stoves, aircraft, diesel is used as a fuel in heavy motors, vehicles, lubricating oil as used as in lubrication, paraffin wax is used as the ointment, candles make the Vaseline, and the bitumen is used as to make the paints and for the road surfacing. Now come to the natural gas. Natural gas is a very important fossil fuel because it is easy to transport through pipes. Natural gas is also used as a starting material for the manufacture of a number of chemicals and fertilizers. And the natural gas is obtained after obtaining the petroleum. In India, natural gas has been found in Tripura, Rajasthan, Maharashtra and in Krishna Godavari Delta. So that the reservoirs of petroleum is also with the natural gas because over the petroleum, the natural gas are mostly deposited. Petroleum conservation in India, the one organization is here, the Petroleum Conservation Research Association, shortly we known as PCRA, advises people how to save petrol, diesel while driving. The tips are here: drive at a constant and moderate speed as far as possible, and switch off the engine at traffic lights or at a place where you have to wait. Ensure correct tire pressure, ensure regularly maintenance of the vehicles. Thank you for watching my video. Thanks.